4 cents. She just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. She was rocking stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off whites. Okay, now wait, wait, wait. Gotta get the bag in racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't honestly. Gotta new press those in the J's in a way. Gotta new press watch, ready, don't take time. I pull up on the off if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. Just do it. Bought them all, my wrist going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They're like, hold up, wait a minute, like, don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey. Hey, yo. Nike check.
Yeah, I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, I came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog.
Today, from TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida, it's week 12 of the NFL on EA Sports. Jacksonville Jaguars taking on the Tennessee Titans.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tennessee Titans and the Jacksonville Jaguars. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
So here's the first drive now for the Jags. And a glance at the tall signal caller, standing 6'6".
That was a solid performance last week, wasn't it? Two touchdowns, no interceptions, ran the team well, won the ball game. Bottom line, may not have been earth-shattering, but it didn't need to be.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Steps away to his left. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, third and 1. An early test, 2 plays in, this is 3rd and 2.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Well, nowhere to throw it, decided to scramble, and a nice job, CD. Got the yardage that he needed.
Yeah, and his teammates are certainly going to appreciate that effort, even if his coaches don't, because they would have wanted him to slide and protect himself. But he chose team gain over personal protection.
To throw here on first down. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. That'll be taken in there by Kenny Golladay. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Good for another Jacksonville first and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Trucks through him.
Oh, man, right through him.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
The tackle made by Jayon Brown. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2 at the Titans 23-yard
line. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And now he's going to use his legs. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. So play number 10 now coming. It's been a long opening drive, but this is third down. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. From 8 yards out. And the Jaguars drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Extra point tacked on by Lambeau, and it's now a 7-0 game. Touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. So the Titans set to go to work for the first time. And a glance here at their quarterback standing 6'3".
Coming off of a loss their last time out, I think he's just seeking to make a bigger impact on the game. He threw a touchdown pass, didn't throw an interception. I think he just wants to jump those numbers up in terms of flinging it around and letting his receivers get into the end zone.
On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And he put up a good fight, but he's going to be taken down behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A loss
loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Derrick Henry. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. Nice move at the 40. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. So time to see Jacksonville again on offense for the second time here in this game. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
And they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Nothing on EA Sports.
Jaguars 7, Titans nothing.
Back to throw now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Flush to his right. He'll try and run it. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And finally taken down at the 15. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 4.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1. Second and goal from the 1.
Brings up second and goal.
They'll try to run this one in. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll try to run this one in. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. With touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead.
Well, he decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker
Davis has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Lambeau on for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away.
This will make it into the end zone.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. They're staring at a 2-touchdown deficit, 14-0 to score as they regroup with 1st and 10. They'll start with the option. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down.
This defense is really fooling around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
So the first play of the drive, lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Now it's Henry. And this looks a lot like the last play. Behind the line of scrimmage, he's tackled for the 2nd straight go-around. Great job by this Jacksonville D. They lose 2 on that last play, so things get even tougher. 3rd and long coming up. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, 3rd and long. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. From 3 yards out, and the Jaguars add 6 to their lead.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Lambeau to add on the extra point. And it is now 21-0.
It is good.
A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only 1 play to score it. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The intended receiver there was Jonnu Smith. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Got a man, and he hits him in stride.
The pass.
And he will have a Titans 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. And he'll get this underneath to Henry. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Derrick Henry. a gain of
22. Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll look to throw again. Henry's got it out on the left side. That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles where he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal game.
He finds Corey Davis. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And the Jags have 5 in the secondary here on third down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Jacksonville's pass defense holds serve. Fourth down.
Intended for number 16. Incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They'll run for it with Henry. And down inside the 15 he goes. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. First down on a pickup of 11. They only needed about 4 or 5 inches there. Relied on the big guys up front and got it done.
Yeah, this is the time to just go ahead and hit it straight ahead. No juking, right? No movement in the backfield. Take the ball and go. As I heard a coach tell a player a long time ago, save your dancing for the club, son. Just get up into that line of scrimmage.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. There's another example, another incompletion.
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, bye weeks, they're over. We've once again got a full slate of games to get to as we take you around the NFL here in Week 12. We'll get started up at Lucas Oil Stadium in the capital city of Indianapolis. And it's the Steelers out in front in the second quarter. The Steelers still in a dogfight, but this would be a good victory for them if they could get it. From there, it's off to North Carolina to check on the Panthers at home in Charlotte. And for the moment, they trail the visiting Saints in that one. 2 touchdown passes there for Jameis Winston. Finally, let's get up to the place they call Titletown, Green Bay, Wisconsin, to see what's happening with the Packers. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Chiefs. Aaron Rodgers carving them up with 3 touchdown passes. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
For Jacksonville.
The Titans going to get the ball to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back to it. On EA Sports, taken about 7 yards deep. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback.
Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively.
And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. He'll air this one out deep for Dayton. He's got a man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big pickup of 38.
Still all sorts of time left in this game, and you'd like to be able to say take it one play at a time. But the truth is, they're probably going to have to hit on a few big plays in the passing game to close this gap, and that's a good start right there.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On the RPO, that's complete right side. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Was that a design pass, or what was that?
It was built into the play call. He had the opportunity to either hand it inside, keep it himself to run it, or do what he just did. Throw that pass inside, hitting a receiver on the run.
First down carry for Henry, and he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just to their ears back and get after him now.
And he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Henry. Now a timeout being called as there's an injured Titan down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They'll try the field goal now with Graham Gano. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18.
Titans 3.
So a good drive there to begin quarter number 3, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need them to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. A big reason why they've been so successful, this defense hasn't been able to contain him when he gets outside of the pocket.
So true, and that's when it's really difficult because defensively you can have a game plan and try and account for all the things you've seen on tape, the way that they run their plays, even his running. But when it's a play where you just can't really say, okay, that's how the play's supposed to go, what they call broken plays, that's when the X and O doesn't work. That's when their Jimmy is better than your Joe.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin too.
Second and 9 now. This is Chenault on the receiving end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
And again, this time to the tailback. Good burst there. Gets him seven. Up to midfield.
The ball carrier.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Now they'll try the jet sweep here. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
Good for the Jaguars.
An excellent run there coming from out wide.
And we used to consider these jet sweeps to be gadget plays or something a little bit unusual, right? But now most teams have some version of this play in their playbook. And I think it's a lot because of the receivers that are being developed nowadays. These guys look like running backs, even though they're playing out on the perimeter.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now back to throw. He'll get this one to Gallaudet. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll look to throw here. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. And Charles, the defender, was there. He just didn't get it.
Sometimes these plays turn into basketball in a sense, with two guys going up for the football. Which guy's going to box the other away from it and grab it?
Yeah, I know you hear it a lot, but it's just the will to get it, right?
Oh, without a doubt, the will, as well as some really nice touch on the ball that was thrown.
And some talent, too. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. So the drive there took six plays, and it culminates in a Jags touchdown.
Three. Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard
line. Here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They've got to dig down deep. They need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at that time, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working.
Second and six.
Over the middle to Smith. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
First down, Titans.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And right side, Henry's got it. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. 38-yard line, second and 9. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 38-yard line. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
So the ball moves from 1:38 to the other as they come up on first and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. They set up the screen for Henry. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four.
Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Back to throw again. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. The Titans on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 14. Back to throw. Smith catches left side. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big body.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll get this one up to about his 14.
Taken down.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Now a handoff looking right. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Nice third down conversion at even 20 yards.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Now they try the right side here. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Third and 4.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he'll find Galladay. That's complete. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
It's now third and 4.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand.
11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
Really? Really? Did we just see that? That's a big catch. One-handed, I might add, to pick up a first down.
I was going
to
say, on third down for the defense, it's one thing to give up a reception. You just got to shake your head on a one-handed catch to pick up the first. Now a handoff looking right. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you'll only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you one or two more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
2 yards, good enough for a first.
At the 19-yard line.
They'll run here with Coleman out of the gun. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And Jones has it over the middle. And the Jags are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Jacksonville, and it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points, that lone field goal in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage, offense sells tickets, defense does what?
Wins championships.
And in this game, maybe a championship wasn't won, but a game was by the defense, right? Held them to just a field goal? That's a heck of a job. I mean, when they went out there with that determination and a pretty good game plan, pretty good idea of what they wanted to accomplish, just love the execution, love the tenacity, love the way they finished.
So for the Jags, the perfect season remains intact as they move to 11-0 on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Titans, they've fallen out of things now as they sink to 3-8. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.